afternoon. I'm Jessica Loper with the county. Thank you so much for being here. Just want to kind of give you an overview of how this is going to work. We're going to have our chair, Julia Olson-Bozeman, speak to you, provide some remarks and updates from the county in terms of guidance we want to provide to our citizens. After that, we'll open it up to questions from the media. We've also got our Facebook Live going, and we'll answer media questions that way as well if needed. We have our subject matter experts here that she will call up, so you may be introduced to them as well, but want to make sure you hold your questions to the end. She'll provide that statement, and then you'll have that opportunity. Thank you.
Good afternoon, and thank you for being here. And thank you to our residents who are watching on Facebook. I want to recognize my fellow commissioners who are here with me today, Madam Vice Chair Patricia Kuzak, Commissioner Rob Zappel, and Commissioner Woody White. We are united as County Commission, and we will do whatever it takes to protect the health, safety, and welfare of every citizen in New Hanover County. I would also like to recognize some of our subject matter experts who are here with us and will be on hand for questions in just a few minutes. Our Public Health Preparedness Coordinator, Lisa Brown, Personal Health Services Manager, Carla Turner, Emergency Management Director, Stephen Sill, and New Hanover Regional Medical Center Chief Clinical Officer, Dr. West Paul. There have been a lot of changes for our community over the past week. We went from business as usual for many to no school, working from home, canceling large events, and limiting our social interactions. I want to state up front, there are no confirmed tests of COVID-19 in New Hanover County. And the measures we are taking now will help to ensure our community is as protected and safe as possible from this virus. This is uncharted territory, and it's unsettling for most people. But I hope the county's message of being prepared and not panicked can continue to resonate with all of us. I also want to remind you, the community, of our Ready NHC pillars: make a plan, build a kit, and stay informed. I have to say, I have been incredibly impressed how our community has reacted. You have come together, you are supporting each other, and you're now remembering the most vulnerable in our community who need our help now more than ever. Our Senior Resource Center staff are providing a drive-through lunch option for customers who participate in the Congregate Meals program at the facility on College Road and at the satellite site in Castle Hayne. You can learn more about this option at nhcgov.com or by calling 910-798-6420. The Senior Resource Center will also continue operating the Home Delivered Meals program for its registered homebound participants and will be regularly calling and contacting our seniors to check in, say hello, and make sure that they have what they need. Our schools have implemented their summer feeding program that will allow children and families to pick up in a walk-up or drive-through setting free breakfast and lunch at 14 schools, and that started today. You can learn more at nhcs.net. There's also a lot of work happening with our community groups. The Brigade Boys and Girls Club is providing meals for families with children ages 5 through 18, and families can receive 2 meals each day per child, Monday through Saturday, 10 to 2, at the Teen Center at 2759 Vance Street, and the Houston Moore Community at 1601 South 13th Street. Several restaurants in the community are offering free meals while schools are closed, and offering curbside services to promote social distancing. Utilities like Duke Energy and Cape Fear Public Utility Authority are suspending delinquency-related service disconnections. Starting today, Spectrum will begin offering broadband and Wi-Fi access to households with K-12 and college students who don't already have a subscription. You can find this information and other community resources through our New Hanover County Disaster Coalition partners at newhanoverdisastercoalition.org. We are grateful to the coalition for the incredible support and collaboration during this time. Most human service organizations remain operational and are conducting customer interactions and assessments by phone, and that includes our own social services department. Our emergency financial assistance team can conduct assessments and interviews over the phone, and we are awaiting confirmation from our state partners that other programs can do the same. We ask all of our residents to call ahead before coming to a county building to conduct business. We may still be able to help you over the phone or in another matter that promotes social distancing. We appreciate the governor's request today to the Small Business Administration for a disaster declaration for business owners facing economic loss because of COVID-19. We know this will be a challenging time for our local businesses and that more that can be done to help them fulfill their financial obligations and operating expenses, the better. I want to thank our community for all you are doing and for listening to our public health and government officials. This is incredibly important at a time like this. The county has shared community guidance measures that are consistent with state and CDC mitigation measures. I encourage you to take a look at the document because it does a good job of outlining things that individuals, community organizations, residential facilities, healthcare settings, childcare facilities, and employers should be doing now to prepare, as well as what to do if there is a confirmed case of COVID-19 in New Hanover County. You can find it at health.nhcgov.com. As you all know, the government has ordered all K-12 schools to be closed for at least the next 2 weeks. He has also ordered that events and gatherings with more than 100 people be canceled. This includes events in a single room or space, such as an auditorium, stadium, arena, large conference room, meeting hall, theater, or other confined indoor or outdoor space, including parades, fairs, and festivals. At this time, the governor's ban on gatherings does not include airports, bus and train stations, medical facilities, libraries, shopping mall, and spaces where people may be in transit. Office environments, restaurants, factories, or retail or grocery stores are also included. In addition to this order and at the guidance of the CDC, the governor of New Hanover County are recommending that gatherings with more than 50 people be canceled for at least the next 8 weeks. New Hanover County also recommends that events with 10 or more people who are at a high-risk population be canceled. We fully expect our community to follow this guidance, and we will be managing our own county spaces and operations to comply with this. We have to protect those who are 65 years and older and who have underlying health conditions because they are at the most of the complications at risk, at the most risk of complications from this virus. And we also have to protect ourselves and our families. Those measures are about reducing the spread of COVID-19 so we don't have an epidemic across the state or locally, and so we don't enter a phase of infection known as community spread. Please continue to be vigilant, and I'm going to say it one more time, although I know by now you have all done this. Wash your hands frequently for 20 seconds, use hand sanitizer often, cover your mouth when you cough or sneeze with a tissue, and stay home and away from others if you are sick. I am proud of our county government for the leadership shown and the way we responded to protect the public and support our employees. We have ramped up cleaning and disinfecting at all county buildings and are encouraging staff to practice social distancing. And that has meant changing locations for meetings, canceling some trainings, and encouraging staff to work from home when able. At this time, we plan to move forward with our Board of Commissioner meeting on Monday, March the 23rd, but do so remotely. We will provide information to the community on how to tune in and access that meeting later this week. We have also suspended all business travel until further notice, and we have canceled all county-sponsored group events and activities. That means Cape Fear Museum, Airlie Gardens, the Arboretum, our public libraries, and parks and gardens will not have any planned events. But at this time, they are open for visitors. The county is open for business and operating consistent with the governor's orders and CDC guidance, and we are actively working with our employees because we want to offer them maximum flexibility while ensuring that business can continue. We have extended our sick and personal leave policies so that employees do not have to take unpaid time off if they are confronted with an illness, if they are caring for someone who is sick, or if they are caring for a child who is out of school. Additionally, in the event one of our dedicated public employees is exposed to COVID-19 in the course of their work and need to be self-quarantined or isolate themselves, we do not expect them to use personal leave. That is time the county will grant them individually. Departments are evaluating staff, alternating employee schedules to allow for more staggered hours and, as is appropriate, encouraging staff to conduct business on the phone, via teleconference, or cancel it if it isn't time sensitive. We're all going to need extra patience during this time, but just so you know that the county is working on your behalf, and we will work hard to continue the same superior service to all of you over the next coming weeks. Beginning at 9 a.m. tomorrow, Tuesday, March the 17th, a public health coronavirus call center will be set up for residents to call with questions about the virus. This call center will be staffed by our public health nurses, who will also be able to help people connect with a provider who can determine if a flu test or COVID-19 test is needed. We will also have mental health counselors available for consultation in the call center. This call line will be open Monday through Friday from 7:30 a.m. to 6 p.m., and the number is 910-798-6800. This will be a great resource for our residents. Again, the call center will open tomorrow at 9 a.m., and the number is 910-798-6800. If you have a fever and respiratory symptoms like coughing and shortness of breath and have not had any contact with someone who has COVID-19, the current state protocol for testing involves getting a flu test first. Right now, it is still more likely that you get the flu, so the current guidance requires that flu is ruled out first. If the flu test comes back negative, then a provider may determine you need a test for COVID-19. Your provider will give you instructions to stay home until your test results come back, and that is really, really important to keep our community safe. Our public health team has been and will continue to coordinate sampling, collections, and testing with the state's public health lab. In addition, physicians can work with a private lab to conduct the test for COVID-19. At this time, our public health department has more than 60 collection kits, and we are actively working to increase that number. The sampling abilities in our community extend beyond those 60 kits, though, because we have private labs who are also able to facilitate samples and testing. We're actively working with the state and private labs daily to ensure they continue to have the capacity for tests that are sent their way. We are constantly monitoring supplies and capacity, and we'll prioritize testing for our residents who are at higher risk of serious illness if needed. As a reminder, please call ahead before showing up to any doctor's office or health clinic and share your symptoms with them, and they can prepare accordingly. And do not go to the hospital emergency room unless you have a true emergency. To help eliminate the number of people who are going into physician offices and to increase our services to the community, it is our plan, sometime early next week, for the county's public health department to begin implementing a new process to deploy health nurses directly to residents in a safe manner after they are pre-screened and referred by our call center. Based on the availability of supplies, our nurses would then be able to conduct flu testing and then COVID-19 sampling if necessary. This will enhance our public health response, and I'm grateful to our staff who are making this happen. We're also working with New Hanover Regional Medical Center and our healthcare community to collaborate on a drive-through COVID-19 sampling location here in our county if health officials determine that this is needed. Our hope is that coming to you and offering referral service will ease the need for a drive-through location. But we are working through the logistics now and planning in case we need to put this in place. The state is also working on this effort, and we will be collaborating with them as well. If this is needed in our community, we will be ready. We have some of the most dedicated and committed public servants here at the county who have been working tirelessly, many for some weeks, to be proactive and put plans in place to keep our community safe. We don't know what the coming days will come, but I assure you that your county government is here. And from what I've seen over the past few days, our community is listening, and you are preparing and responding. I encourage you to remember others during this time. Reach out to your elderly friends and neighbors to check on their well-being and offer any assistance you can. If you're in this position to help coworkers, family, or friends with childcare responsibilities since our schools are out, please do. And avoid overstocking food, water, and household goods. Grocery stores are being unnecessarily overwhelmed and need time to restock. Above all, please remain calm, don't panic, have your own plans in place to keep yourself and your family safe and healthy. Again, remember our Ready NHC pillars. Make a plan, build a kit, and stay informed. You can find all of the up-to-date information about COVID-19 and our public health efforts at health.nhcgov.com. Now I will take a few questions from the media and we'll call up other subject matter experts if needed to answer your questions.
And we do have a microphone over here if you want to use it. That way our folks on Facebook can hear your question. If you don't, then our chair will repeat your question.
Hello, I know we don't have any confirmed cases in New Hanover County. How many people have been tested in the county?
As of today, our public health department is aware of 28 COVID-19 tests that have been taken in New Hanover County. Two tests have gone from public health to the state and are pending. 26 tests have gone through private labs from physician offices. There are a handful of tests pending currently, and otherwise all other tests have come back negative. We are working to confirm this number as I speak.
And obviously, we have a case in Onslow County, Brunswick County. Was there a sense of urgency, I guess, once those came about, or was this always in the works? As far as the measures that we're taking today with a call center starting up tomorrow and next week people may be going out to houses.
Well, we've instructed the county staff to be extremely vigilant, and we're not going to wait on orders from the government or from the federal level, that we want to be prepared as we can be. And we're fortunate that we have a great staff and we're doing that without being ordered to do it.
So with emphasis on the older population and kids being out of school, is it still okay for them for grandparents or whoever else to be around those children who may be inadvertently carrying it?
Well, I think that if the only solution is for grandparents to take care of their children and that's the only way, then that is something that parents will have to decide to do. But it's equally important to make sure that this child is not going on play dates or going to be around other populations that they can somehow expose our most vulnerable.
Okay. And so a similar question, if parents go to work, would it be better for a teenager or a college student to be at home looking over a child instead of a grandparent?
Yes.
Is the county coordinating an emergency plan with the hospital?
Yes, we're in constant contact. If y'all want to come up, we're in constant contact with the hospital. We have our EOC is up and running at a minimal basis with just county staff being there. And yes, we are constantly talking to the hospital and working together.
And we do that on a regular basis. So that's not something that is new to our COVID-19 efforts in any way. We've been doing that very regularly. Definitely as long as I can remember. We worked together very closely through the Healthcare Coalition. We worked together very closely during hurricanes. We exercised. Some of you joined us in October for the flu through, where we practiced doing that mass vaccination effort with flu vaccine. That was in partnership with the hospital and with public health and some other partners. So it's not something that's new, but obviously, given what we're dealing with COVID-19, we've had more specialized discussions.
Tell them who you are.
Oh, sorry. I'm Lisa Brown. I'm the Public Health Preparedness Coordinator.
And is the hospital prepared with enough beds and reverse pressure rooms? Negative pressure rooms.
Hi, I'm Dr. Westfall. I'm the Chief Clinical Officer at New Hanover Regional Medical Center. Yes, we've actually been planning on this since the emergence out of China. Our infection control committees have been meeting since December. Our incident command center went live on Friday, but we had been planning up to 2 to 3 weeks prior. We've got a complete assessment. We have over 50 negative pressure rooms that are available. We can actually turn whole floors into negative pressure rooms. Hopefully it won't come to that, but the plan is quite good, and the resources that we have, we feel are adequate at this point.
Any other questions?
So I know a lot of businesses are still operating
as of now. They're currently open. So I guess my question is, are you guys going to wait for direction from Raleigh on further action regarding those businesses and the status of their closings, possibly, or anything like that?
We don't have any authority to tell businesses what to do at this point unless we declare a state of emergency, and we are all hopeful that with all the precautions that the county has taken and the residents are taking, that that will not happen. If that's it, thank you all for being here, and please be safe. Wash your hands, listen to the recommendations, practice social distancing, and don't touch your face. Thank you.